anybody for this week? To start?
We had great problems with them last night.
I don't know.
As it's a Merseyside wide, why does Stuart at the same time. Bring them all in.
Chair, to address that, if everybody's on a different stage in the process at the moment, and obviously different cycles of committees. But if we were all at the same stage, I accept that would be a proposal, but it may take other authorities a little bit longer.
Okay.
Thank you, Chair.
We suggest that you accept it and we've got two
months. 2 months. Okay. Is that agreed?
Yeah, agreed.
The next item.
Thank you, Chair. The purpose of this report is for members to consider representations that we see in respect of the proposed increase to the Hackney Carriage fare tariff, which was advertised in the form of the decision made by this committee on the 25th of November. As members are aware, there were two representations and they have been supplied to members for their consideration. The purpose of tonight's meeting really is for members to consider those representations and whether or not to approve the fare increase as proposed at the last committee meeting. And there are representations on the trade here this evening, Chair.
Okay then, so any comments from the councillors? No? Right.
All stands as it was, the one that's
passed. It stands as it is,
yeah.
Okay.
All stands.
We object to a fair increase.
Well, can you come and tell us why then, please?
The chair.
The chair.
The one.
Can't you name first?
Yeah, Chris Howell.
Yeah, and who's your representative?
I'm just representing me. I'm just a Hackney Cans driver.
Okay.
Which I'm self-employed, so.
Okay.
Now, as a trade, we're facing a squeeze from all sides. We've got drivers hiring, we've got Uber, we've got everyone piling in. Now, Uber is a big problem. Because not only are the fact they're not based here, you know, the money they earn from doing Wirral Council things goes
much help you have to do.
It's what I'm trying to say. I know the same people who are living through the press. I don't get a local at the start, and I know a local lot of people don't get it. So they have no idea that the fares are going to go up, or how to get to the fair increase. Now, unless we tell them.
Well, we've got no control of the free papers.
But if you don't put up 20 pence, why don't you upfront that? Tell them, and I've actually tried to say just email the council for it. They just don't listen. I mean, the young folks out there still use both day, we get it in. You stand outside, at the moment, they stand outside, how much square station they're using. And they'll phone back and say, because it's cheaper than us, and we're sitting over the road. Also, it's your name to make that gap.
Advertising yourself is 50 pence, or have happy hours and things like that. value the same things?
Would you just stay there then? Does anyone have one ask a question?
Sorry, Chair, if I could just come back on one comment from, I know you didn't mean it, Derek, but you said that you got the fees up in spite, for spite. As you know, the fees are worked out on a cost basis, and we can only recover the costs of the service through the fees, and they are worked out on an annual basis.
With the greatest respect, I said he didn't, right?
Say, Bill, look, this has been almost 5 years. As our friend here said, it's 2012. £20 on a fare, it won't even be on every fare. People will give you a tip now, I'm going to give you a bigger tip. I calculated today, I do 15 jobs a day, which is about average. You would give me £1 per day, £5 a week. That £5 a week does not pay the increase that I pay to run a taxi. It costs more to taxi, more to insure it, and more to repair it. And the 3 or 4 pence he's talking about going off the fuel is insignificant. The cost of living is more expensive. This administration that you run here, you're getting cut from central government. You've got to cut something. I can't cut anything. I can't run with no insurance or run on all the times. This is nonsense. This has gone on now for 3 committee meetings over 20 pence over almost 5 years. And it's high time this was nipped in the bud and moved forward with.
Now, I'm going to take questions and then I am going to ask for the decision because I'm not, because you've got 500 different views, as you said. What says you can?
Certainly, you can look into the legality of it. I think it's illegal to have another means of starting at a higher rate, and that's been ignored for years and years. So the idea that the public are protected in all this is total nonsense. I've got a service meter which is set and authorised by a proper engineer, and I've got the tariff sheet that you gave me in 2012, and that's what I run off, as do many other people. I haven't got a radio from a private hire office to start on £3.20, and with some sort of tariff sheet that makes no sense, and it's fair and a half and there's 5 people. That's an enforcement issue that needs addressing.
Okay. So again, I'll come back just a minute.
It's thanks for that. It's just an observation. I appreciate that as an individual you can come along to represent yourself. Derek is speaking on behalf of the union, a union that counts, so to speak. And I
Gary, he does not wait.
I don't wait for that. There are, but how many of your union members work for these private hire companies and are asking for an increase in the Hackney fare?
I'm on. Big disagreements down there. I want to tell you again, one speaker and one speaker only. Right.
Well, I was just saying, this is getting off the subject, isn't it? There's somebody down there. But another thing is that even though there's also one, it can be worked for Scott, is that there's a petition ready to go in with this testimony signed by every Scott driver, every single Scott driver. That is impossible to think about.
Right, well, check with you. Sam, you remember the Derek's union before I take you on board? Guys are back.
I am, yeah. But I just want to know why the day rate, when we get this pay rise, is going to be more expensive than the night rate. It's good. From Liscard to New Brighton, it's £4.
It
wasn't just the union, it was Tommy Brome for Birkenhead Drivers and all that lot as well. It wasn't just the union.
That's the trade.
Yeah.
That's
I don't know
yet.
Right, I'm going to take other speakers from the council and then we're going to go to vote because I think we'll have all different views here. Anybody else want to speak from the council?
Yeah, that's fine,
I'm sure.
That's fine.
No other business, Marcus?
Good.
No. So thanks for the attention.